Hey guys, what's up? Bisectatron here from Clash of Clans Manual, bringing you guys the 2,000 subscriber celebration video that I promised, and unfortunately I wasn't able to have a whole lot of live coverage from this. I was actually spending a lot of my time planning out my attacks, a lot of strategizing, but to make up for not having a whole lot of live stuff, I'm going to go ahead and show some of the tools that my clan uses to plan attacks in a later video. But this one is about all of the great attacks from the most recent arranged matchup against WHF2, part of the WHF family, very good family of clans. I think this is just one of their clans, kind of like how we have OneHive 2.0. So they did a great job. Both clans did good. We just were able to take care of the Town Hall 9s a little bit better. So I'm going to show quite a few attacks today just because I promised I'd have an extra long recap video for you guys. So looking at what we did, all three Town Hall 10s were two-starred, and then everything else was three-starred. On the other side, we had, or it looks like they, same thing, all the Town Hall 10s were two-starred, and then it looks like they left, I think like seven or eight, maybe six, seven, or eight, I didn't count exactly, but they left some of our top Town Hall 9s, including me, two-starred, so good try, but they kind of struggled with the Town Hall 9s. But definitely a fun war. I had a lot of fun playing, competing in it. So I'm going to go ahead and get to the attacks. I want to show a few Town Hall 10s, a few Town Hall 9s, and a few Town Hall 8s. All right, so we're going to start all the way at the top with Pendragon going for two stars in this Town Hall 10. And remember that in these close wars, sometimes it ties, and then it comes down to percentage points. So he's obviously making sure he gets as high percentage as he can, plus the Town Hall. 50% isn't going to cut it most of the time. But anyway, comes in with a bunch of golems here. Wall breaks in, kind of has a wall breaker fail on the right side, but gets in on the left side. So most of his golems going in, plus some giants, just to soak up some of those Inferno streams. CC troops come out, a lot of goblins, then a dragon and a balloon. It has the poison and then the new freeze. Remember, can freeze those air troops, so it gets them plus the Inferno, a very high value freeze. Everything making its way in, golems tanking, giants tanking, and then he pops the king's ability, who's going to mow through some of the heroes, then get on that town hall. That dragon is still up, but I think a shot from the queen should get it. Still has a few archers he's deploying around the outside, plus those minions which he dropped, which were great, because just gets free percentage from that. Has a lot of tanks up still. That one balloon is kind of doing some work on those golems just because the queen is back and she can't take it out. But doesn't matter. Still going to get a pretty solid percentage out of this. Level 40 queen still has the ability, so still quite a few percentage points left from her. You can see up at 55%, 58. Those golems should get the Inferno Tower also. Nothing's really shooting at the queen. The archer tower's on her now, so needs to use the ability. But should get that Inferno as well, I think. Yeah, and then that King Pad. So up to 62%, which is a very solid attack. And especially our number 3, so not even our top guy, going up there. Looks like his King is level 38. So not a big difference, but goes up and gets about 60, 65% is what you want to get. So awesome job to Pendragon. Moving along, we're also going to look at number 3, Jelly. Also like this attack, using some hogs. Jelly is a Town Hall 9, so he's going up to take out a Town Hall 10. Has those level 30 heroes, which helps. Dropping down 5 golems, just letting them tank for a little while before he wall breaks them in. And then has some wizards to back it up. Drops his queen. You can see the enemy king's coming out. His heroes will engage him, and then they'll take out the queen as well. Looks like he's going to drop that jump. Yeah, there it goes. I don't remember these attacks perfectly just because I've watched a lot, too many in this video to memorize what happens in each one. But anyway, CC troops come out, has a poison for those skellies as well. A lot of DPS. You can see those quad Teslas popping. So just a lot going on in this area. But has a lot of hit points out in front. Those golems will tank for a while. So queen is completely protected. she's free to shoot down that CC dragon, and then she'll get on the town hall in just a moment. And then I like these hogs. You can see heal spell and just 10 hogs. They're going to make their way in and take out quite a few defenses. So he leaves his minions room to basically just get all these free buildings. Hogs on the expo, and is it going to go down? I think it does go down. Well, no, it looks like it doesn't go down. But it's a ground targeting expo, so it can't shoot those minions anyway. So it doesn't matter. Still one minion left in the bag, and you can see as long as they don't hit any traps, they should be able to take out quite a few percentage. We'll fast forward as they get these last few buildings taken out. There we go. And then, they'll get the drill, and then I think the storage. Yeah, so 55%. Any kind of two-star by a Town Hall 9 on a Town Hall 10 is good, especially getting the extra 5% helps, because it could come down to it. It has in many one-hive wars. So nice attack to Jelly going up and getting the 2-star. All right, now we're going to take a look at another attack, 007, using some Valks, which is always fun to see. Dropping down 2 golems and then some wizards. Free wizard on that archer tower, which is nice. A good trade there. And then a wizard up top to create the funnel. So everything is going to be funneled in just a moment. Need a nice wide funnel for those Valks. Drops them perfectly. King behind. And then they're going to make their way on in. Lava Hound comes out. A lot of times people, we're seeing this more often, just don't use the Queen in the Kill Squad when there's a Lava Hound, because the Queen will just get stuck on the Lava Hound, and it won't be very helpful. So I'm not sure what he does with his Queen, actually. He hasn't deployed her yet, I don't think. So I can't remember exactly. But anyway, dropping those Hogs down. Used a few to flank the Kill Squad just so no defenses could flank it, I guess. So good use of a few surgical hogs at the beginning. Then comes in with his main group right there in that expo. You can see the double giant bomb set was triggered by the Kill Squad, which is great. And then they got another single bomb, it looks like, in the core, plus all those Teslas. So really great value out of those Valks. And there's a lot of buildings concentrated in one area, like there was on this base. It's always a good use. And then he just drops the Queen up, take out a few defenses. Didn't really need her for anything too big in this raid. It was mostly just the Hogs and the Kill Squad. You can see he has cleanup wizards all around. That's going to do it, basically. That Lava Hound stuck on a Golemite, which is great. As long as the Queen's not shooting it, that's always a benefit. And last few buildings go down at the bottom here. And that's going to do it. Awesome job to 007. Had a 6-star war, by the way, so great job. I was going to go down one and take a look at Lord Byron. Just a nice 2-golem Goho. Pretty classic attack. Go ahead and get this started. Where's he coming in from? All right, up here. 2 golems go down, wizards to back it up. Queen, typical stuff. Getting a nice wide funnel. And here comes the king. Drops a jump spell. That's going to connect the queen, and I believe there's double giant bombs there, so this guy was pretty nice putting the double giant bomb so close to the queen. Could just use that one jump and get both of them. So you can see in just a moment the golem should walk over that double set right there, and then comes in with the hogs. I think that's the only double giant bomb set in the whole base, so just has to make sure he heals his hogs over the single bombs, and he's pretty much good for this attack. Has 30 hogs, so can definitely take out a big part of this base, and still has some golems tanking. That Lava Hound is up, but the Queen's not near it, so that's always good. Queen takes out Tesla. She's doing some work on that side. She'll get a few more point defense, and then has that last heal for the hogs over that giant bomb that'll go off right there. So awesome attack to Lord Byron. The main story of this was just putting the double giant bombs too close to the Queen, because if you can just use one jump and connect them really easily, it's not going to turn out well for the base. So great job exploiting that by Lord Byron. And we'll go ahead and fast forward. Lava Hound pops, but no big deal. And that'll do it. Alright. Next we have one to show. Air taking out number 9. Like this attack. 4 healers. I think Air is a pretty big fan of the Queen Walk. I see him doing it a lot. Only level 23 Queen, 20 King, so not like high heroes really kind of mid-level for Town Hall 9. But anyway, does a great job with the Queen Walk. I like that Hog right there. Both point defense are distracted, so I can go ahead and get a one-for-one trade. And that Hog will keep moving in. I believe it gets the Archer Tower, too. The Tesla's pop right there. But the Queen's going to step up and then has the Rage there to keep the Queen up because there's a lot of point defense on her. One more Hog just to get in there and I believe get the CC lure. He does get the whole lure plus a Skelly Trap, so it gets quite a bit of defensive units lured out. It's another P.E.K.K.A. in the CC, so it has to use the ability right here because one shot from the P.E.K.K.A. will pretty much do the Queen, pretty much kill her. I don't know if it'll quite kill her. It's going to be close for level 23 Queen, but definitely don't want to take the risk. Good job using the ability. And then the Queen continues on her walk. She's going to meet up with the Kill Squad over here. You can see has the Golem and then some Wizards to create the funnel. Jump spell to let everything on in. The Queen will hop that wall, and then the King should get on her in just a moment. You can see his Queen's making her way back in with the Kill Squad. So everything's meeting up nicely. The healers even get on the King, which I guess is a bonus because he's taking a lot of damage now, but he's being healed up. And they also heal up those Barbarians. So good value from those healers. And then starts in with the Hogs here. I think I missed a little bit of this. But basically has the Hogs coming in from every angle and just using those two heals. But they're safe from giant bombs. Ton of Hogs left up. Base went down really quickly once he deployed the Hogs. You can see they get, you know, a few of them get that giant bomb. But the pathing works out, so none of them are too injured by it. And they'll go ahead and clean up this base. Wizards around the outside, as usual. We'll fast forward. Alright, nice attack to air. Moving along, got some more to look at. That was one of mine. Oase, I think it is. Taking out this base and using 8 Valks. So pretty big investment with the Valks here, but gets good value from them. You can see it's at 257, so only had about 3 seconds left when he finished this attack, so came down to the wire. But you can see 2 Golems go down and then drop in a test wall breaker. Has to go heavy on wall breakers because I think the Queen's in range of them. And whenever that's the case, you got to make sure you have an extra wall breaker or two just so you can bust in for sure. Nothing worse than a wall breaker fail. But anyway, gets the wall breakers to open that up and then has a jump to let everything on in to the next compartment. Also has a second jump, which is going to let them deeper into the base. So big investment in the Valks using 2 jumps to move them around the base. CC comes out, Dragon, and also some Skelly traps pop, but the poison takes care of them. Uses the King's ability. Everything's making its way through real nicely. Those Valks are going to take that jump again. And then has the second one to let everything in to basically where the King is and where the double giant bombs are likely going to be. Uses a heal on them, which is, if you're going to invest 8 Valks into an attack, you got to bring a heal. Just because my philosophy is always you put your spells where your troop space is. So if you're investing a lot of troop space in Valks, bring a heal for them. And if you're investing a lot in Hogs, like 30 Hogs, bring, you know, at least 2, probably 3 heals. But anyway, the Valks take out the Tesla farm and trigger those giant bombs, so it gets great value there. The Hogs go in there and trigger the other double set one at a time, which is really nice, and then has quite a bit of Hogs left over, and then also a few Valks. So kind of going at a weird angle, but the Hogs are going to make their way around the base. You can see they're taking out this mortar here. Then they'll go over to that wizard tower. Has a few extra wall breakers just to... they actually do a little bit of splash damage on that cannon, so I guess it's worth deploying them. Anyway, the King's up there tanking, and then the last few Hogs are going to make their way over. Stuff's getting pretty low on health, but has just enough to get the job done. And you can see Wizards at the bottom for cleanup. All that's pretty much left is this HP at the bottom. We'll fast forward because it does take a while, but has the time to do it. One Hog in there, and then some Wizards eventually make their way in. Nice attack to Oase. Alright. So that's going to conclude part 1. I'll have part 2 up in just a few moments. Alright, so just had to split it into 2 different parts. But right back here with the attacks, next one we're looking at is Bigatroth on number 18. So kind of a lower level Town Hall 9, has a lot of Town Hall 8 defenses, but obviously has all the traps and all the typical Town Hall 9 stuff. Coming in with a Golem here, gonna go all the way to that cannon, drawing a lot of fire so can get a nice wide funnel going. Pretty much a stone, or sorry, a cold-blooded Goho with, or shattered Goho. What am I saying? With so two Golems, and then bringing in quite a few Hogs. Just gonna basically bust in, get the Queen, and then I believe get to that double giant bomb set, which is by that air defense. Between the air defense and the wizard tower up there. These guys have a lot of P.E.K.K.A.s in their CC, which, you know, didn't do a whole lot. It'll go down pretty quickly, especially to a bunch of wizards and stuff. And its attack speed is super slow on that poison. Anyway, though, his heroes are nice and protected behind those golems. They go ahead and get the king and the queen taken out. You can see his king's still at full health, so really got a lot of value from those golems. Did a lot of tanking. And then double giant bomb sets triggered, coming in with the hogs, and has gonna have his first heal for them right here, on that wizard tower. Sorry, and then I had the sacrificial hogs going across the giant bomb, and last heal goes down. But, yeah, just one defense left. They'll turn around and get those skellies, and then it'll just be cleanup. So nice attack to Bigatroth. Alright, next one we're going to look at last Town Hall 9, I believe. Oh, no, two more Town Hall 9s. So we have 19. Also Bigatroth. Okay, cool. Taken out... but his 19 taken out, our 19 taken out his 19, sorry, starting to lose it in this video. Anyway, though, gets a little bit low on time here. You can see he had about 7 seconds left. Pretty similar attack, bringing a third golem, just do some more tanking, get deeper into the base. His heroes are only 15-16, so sometimes you don't invest that much troop space into tanking for your heroes because they don't do as much damage, but you can do it with, you know, even with kind of low-level heroes like Bigatroth has. Coming in, getting that queen. She actually goes way out, which is kind of weird. But his queen will take her out, so no big deal. Then drops the king as well, who will reroute back into the base. Has the poison spell, taking out the minions, the balloons, all that stuff. Golems are taking quite a bit of damage, but in the meantime, his heroes are taking out defenses. And I think they're going to get in there and trigger some double giant bombs in just a moment. These guys did put their double giant bombs a little bit too close to their queens, so one jump spell could typically connect all that up. You can see the one set going off right there by that expo, and then I believe that golem's going to make its way all the way up and trigger the next set of double giant bombs. So great job with the kill squad there, getting just with one jump can get both those sets plus the queen, and then has the hogs coming through. And one last heal for them on these last few buildings. And then that's going to do it. Just clean it from there. Skelly, oh, the expo too. But a little bit low on hogs, but gets the job done. They turn around, get those skelly traps, and then it's just clean up. Getting these last few buildings, a nice attack to Bigatroth. Keep it up. Alright, last army camp goes down. And we'll go ahead and look at our last Town Hall 9. Which is Stefan, taking out number 20. And I wanted to show this one because it was cool. Use the Suicide Dragons, which is always fun to see. And for those of you who don't know what that is, you'll see it in just a moment. Dropping two golems again, plus some wizards behind. They create the funnel, typical stuff. And then drops those dragons. Their whole purpose just to get in there and take out the queen. Because people put the queen offset from the air defenses to defend from like Go La Loon, you can drop those dragons a lot of the time, especially with these level 4 dragons that are new at Town Hall 9, and take out the queen, and a lot of times get even more value. That one dragon isn't going to get stuck on the town hall, so it'll go down. Maybe not the best investment, but you see this a lot when the queen's a little bit too far to the outside. You can slip two dragons in and take her out, so you don't have to worry about getting your kill squad to that area as well. Lava Hound in the CC. It busts, but the wizards and the queen take out the pups. Hogs coming in, they're going to take out those first layer of defenses and then make their way around the base. It's kind of cool, the kill squad's still tanking for them, so getting great value out of the king, the hogs. That jump spell is really taking them a long way. And then that double giant bomb kind of triggers in a weird way. The king actually sets it off, so it doesn't lose too many hogs to it. And right here, the king and the golem are stuck, but it was kind of interesting how they kind of walked along next to the hogs and did some tanking, which was kind of cool to watch. But anyway, because of that, has so many hogs left over, even another heal for them, so they'll take out those defenses, and then has plenty of cleanup troops to get the job done. Nice attack to Stefan. Kind of cool how everything worked out with the dragons, and then that huge king golem walk with those hogs. Anyway, though, get to some Town Hall 9 action, starting with I Am Sparta, taking out their number 22, and just doing it with a lot of hogs. Has 32 of his own, then I believe 5 in the CC. Dropping down some hogs just to take out those first few defenses. They're going to make their way in as soon as that cannon goes down. CC lure, and then they also get up there, get a skeleton trap. I think he was sniffing for double giant bombs between the wizard tower and the air defense, but there weren't any there. Not that big of a deal, though. Drops the poison just to get all the low HP troops down and then soften up that dragon. That wizard should go down right there, and then has a few more barbs to distract the dragon. Doesn't even drop them, but gets the job done either way. So king goes down, just a tank for both those point defense, dropping another hog on that mortar, and then the CC along with a few of his own, just kind of sprinkling them in behind there. The king's doing all the tanking, so the hogs aren't touched. They're going to make their way in up to that air defense, and then has a heal for them, just kind of sprinkling them in all around the bottom here, a few on that right side by the Tesla, kind of searching for double giant bombs. And then there it goes, sets them off right like that, but only loses about 3 or 4 hogs. Then he drops his, main group of hogs with a nice heal, so everything's meeting up there. Losing quite a few to spring traps, but has a decent amount left, a few more coming on the side, and has another heal which he can drop to keep them up from that king and the skelly traps that are beating on them. His king's still at the bottom, helping with cleanup, which has already started, and then I believe these last few hogs are going to get the job done as they run away from the king there. Just one more defense left. They'll run over and take out that cannon. And then really down to only a few hogs. They have to take out those skelly traps. And then the king, obviously, very close, but I believe that king does go down right here. Like one hog left, one or two hogs, but has ton of wizards left up for cleanup, a few barbarians, nice and spread out, so they'll make their way around, and finally they'll get that dark elixir storage. Nice attack to Sparta, getting the 3-star. It looks like a first attack, but it's always tough on Town Hall 8, because there's so many double giant bomb spots. Alright. We're going to look at Math taking on 24, Sturgical Go Wipe. Anyway, though, just dropping a balloon there. Base builder probably didn't think of that, but you never want to make it so you can just do a balloon on the cannon like that. So easy trade there, gets that cannon taken out. Comes in with a few hogs and a heal spell, so a big investment. But they have to basically get in there and trigger the double giant bomb set. So right there it goes off, so they get the job done, plus the CC lure. Goes ahead and drops the poison, taking out all those CC troops, so pretty good value for those hogs. Get in there, take out defenses, lure the CC, and then also trigger the double giant bomb set, so definitely worth it for the 8 hogs or whatever, plus the heal. Then just comes in with very heavy on that bottom mortar with a heal. It's going to let those hogs work their way to the middle of the base. Giant bomb goes off, but they're under the heel, so won't do much to them. Making their way through, then comes in with some more hogs. I like how the king is kind of tanking for that archer tower, so getting full value from that king. And then last heel goes down, and then the big group of hogs making their way through. All double or all giant bombs are triggered, so not too many threats left, just a few point defense, and it has wizards already starting cleanup. Just has last three defenses, and then the hogs are good to go. It takes a little while for them to make their way around, but we'll fast forward. Yep, Tesla goes down, and then they go ahead and split up, taking out these last few buildings. Awesome attack to math. Keep it up. Alright. Show one more attack, then we'll wrap this thing up. Going all the way down to 34. Gonna show some low-level action. You can see they have pretty similar bases, just everything's a little bit under-upgraded. With the new dark spells, obviously, that opens up the ability to use the two lightning and then the earthquake. So you can basically save a rage spell for your dragons while it's still taking out an air defense. But nice to see a little bit of a drag loon attack at Town Hall 8. 99% of what you see is hogs, but every once in a while you'll see one of these, and it's always cool to see it. Just because it is unique and takes, you know, it looks like a spam attack, but does take some skill to execute it. A lot of planning goes into this. These two air defenses were a little bit too close together. So basically he can just kind of drop his dragons on that top left. They'll get in there along with the balloons and take out both those air defenses really quickly. His own balloons coming in the left here. And those are always good because it's helpful to take out these defenses because the dragons take so long to get to them. You can see a Tesla farm popping right here, so doing quite a bit of damage, but has the balloons and then the dragons making their way in. And once they're locked onto a defense, it'll go down really quickly. The only thing with dragons is they target every building, so if they get stuck on a storage, they can get taken out by a defense while they're on the storage. But once they're on the defense, it'll go down quickly because they do a lot of damage. And you can see how many dragons he has left up. Great attack. This had level 6 air defenses, so not that easy of a base, plus those level, I think it's level 6 Teslas max at Town Hall 8. So, awesome attack to Diego. I like seeing the dragons. Alright, that's going to do it for this long war recap. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I wanted to give you guys a lot of coverage, and then I'll have some more videos coming out. Look for that Q&A coming out tomorrow or Monday, along with kind of an insider video on how we plan out attacks at OneHive Genesis. So it should be a lot of fun. Hope you guys are excited for that. But yeah, that's going to do it. Drop a like if you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later. Bye, Sectatron out.